Hello, everyone. My name is Dr. Ming Zhang. I'm an interventional cardiologist with Weill Cornell Medicine in New York Presbyterian, Queens.
大家好，欢迎您来收看纽约长老会和世界日报合办的健康教育讲座。我是钟明医师，是纽约长老会心脏介入科的主治医师，也是康乃医学院的临床副教授。
Today, I'd like to discuss a topic that's very important to me.Today, we're going to be talking about coronary artery disease and the importance of it.
今天我们将讨论一个对我讲是非常重要的课题，就是冠状动脉疾病。
So my talk today is entitled The Basics of Coronary Artery Disease in 2021. Today, we're going to talk about the basics of coronary artery disease, diagnosing it, preventing it, and of course, treating it.
今天我将跟大家讨论在2021年冠状动脉疾病的基本知识，我们将会包括怎么样预防、怎么样诊断及怎么样治疗。
The heart is a vital organ of the body that is necessary for the entire body to function in all of its organs.
心脏是我们身体一个非常重要的器官，它不但是要担负自己的工作，其他的身体其他部分的细胞跟组织也需要心脏。
At its most basic function, the heart acts like a pump that receives blood and pumps blood to the rest of the body.
心脏最重要的功能呢，是将血液集中到心脏，然后再把这个血液呢打出去。
The heart also needs to receive blood from the veins and deliver blood to the body through the arteries.
心脏呢，自己也需要血液。它的血液从静脉进到心脏，再由动脉，达到身体其他的部分。
The heart is supplied by 3 or 4 large blood vessels called coronary arteries.
心脏的血液进来是靠几个重要的血管，叫做动脉。
Each large coronary artery then branches off into many smaller vessels.
心脏有几个3到4个重要的大血管，那每个大血管呢会分成几个小血管。
Keeping these arteries healthy and free from blockages helps to keep the heart strong and functioning well.
保持这些血管的干净及通顺是非常的重要。
However,The coronary arteries can become diseased and thereby compromise the function of the heart.
但是呢，冠状动脉有的时候也会生病。当它生病的时候呢，就会造成其他心脏及其他身体其他功能的损伤。
One of the most common diseases that can affect the arteries is coronary artery disease.
冠状动脉最重要的疾病呢，就是冠状动脉。阻塞疾病。
In this disease, blockages can slowly build up within the arteries and cause an obstruction or blockage to the flow of blood to the heart.
在这个疾病当中呢，血管里的堵塞物在冠状动脉中堆积，而导致流向心脏的血液受到阻止。
If the heart receives inadequate blood supply,It can become injured and not receive enough oxygen or nutrients to meet the demands of the heart.
如果心脏得不到足够的血液，那就会影响到它得到它的养分及氧气的需要。
The first major question in dealing with coronary artery disease is understanding how it starts in the first place.
要了解冠状动脉疾病，第一个就是要知道它是怎么样造成的。
The question is, how does plaque blocking the arteries get there in the first place?
最重要是要知道为什么这些堵塞物呢会在动脉里头产生。
Atherosclerosis or coronary artery disease is the deposition or depositing of plaque.On the wall of the artery.
动脉粥样硬化呢，是动脉内壁 一些斑块的沉积。
In this process, fats and many other cells can leak through vulnerable areas of the artery and deposit themselves.
这个形成是因为脂肪或发炎细胞透过动脉壁的易损伤的部分呢，渗透并沉积在动脉的管壁。
Over time, as plaques increasingly deposit, the nature of the plaque will change and actually become incorporated into the wall of the artery.
随着时间呢，这些斑块呢会开始变化呢，然后慢慢就会变成这个管壁的一部分，然后造成这个管壁的硬化及狭窄。
This can cause hardening and narrowing of the artery.
如此一来呢，这个动脉就会变得硬化呢，而且这个管道也会变得比较狭窄。
So now that we understand a little bit more about how this disease develops, it's important to discuss how important this disease is to the general population.
现在我们了解冠状动脉疾病呢，是怎么样造成的。那我们来看看这个疾病对一般人民众的影响是什么样。
To answer that question, we should think about how common coronary artery disease is.
要了解这个问题，要知道心脏病呢是有多常见。
It turns out that heart disease is the leading cause of death in the United States, even more than cancer, stroke, or trauma.
心脏病是造成美国居民死亡的主要原因，远远超过癌症、中风或外伤。
In fact, over 650,000 people die each year due to heart disease, which accounts for almost 25% of all deaths that occur within this country.
每年有超过65万的人死于心脏病，约占全部死亡总数的25%。
Out of all the different kinds of heart disease, coronary artery disease is the most common.
在所有心脏病当中，冠状动脉疾病是最常见的。
In fact, over 18.2 million adults have this disease, which will account for over 365,000 deaths each year.
在美国有超过1820万人呢有冠状动脉疾病，它造成的死亡呢率是超过36.5万人。
Beyond just death, coronary artery disease also affects adults by causing over 800,000 heart attacks each year.
除了造成死亡之外呢，在美国，冠状动脉的疾病呢。每年会造成超过80万人呢有心脏病发作的机会。
This is one heart attack every 40 seconds.
几乎每40秒就有人有心脏病发作。
And of all these heart attacks, 20% are silent, where the patient doesn't even know that they've had a heart attack.
在这些心脏病发作的时候呢，20%的人呢是完全没有感觉到。任何事先的预告。
Not only is coronary artery disease very common, it affects all genders and races.
冠状动脉疾病呢很普遍，而且呢是造成不管是性别或是这个种族群里面死亡的第一大或第二大原因。
It is the first or second leading cause of death within the United States across both genders and all racial groups.
据疾病控制中心表示，心脏病是造成美国所有性别与种族群死亡的第一或第二大原因。
So now that we understand the impact of coronary artery disease, how does it affect the heart?
我们现在了解这个疾病对心脏的影响。这个重要或是影响，那我们是要怎么样了解它是怎么个影响心脏呢？
Blockages that build up in the coronary arteries can either be stable or unstable.
这冠状动脉中的斑块呢，可能是稳定的，也可能是不稳定的，有两种。
It is the unstable blockages that are at risk for suddenly rupturing, developing a clot, and causing a heart attack.
不稳定的斑块呢，可能有时候会随时会剥落，然后造成这个阻塞，然后造成心脏病的发作。
In this case, the flow of blood within the artery can be 100% blocked.
有些情况呢，在这种情况之下呢，100%的血液呢会被阻塞住，不能流动。
The area of the heart that no longer receives blood can become damaged or even die.
在那些心脏的部分呢，如果不能够接受到血液的话呢，可能会受到很大的损伤或是死亡。
As such, heart attacks are medical emergencies.
所以呢，心脏病是属于紧急情况。
However, even if a blockage is stable and does not cause a heart attack, the blockage can grow in size and reduce blood flow to the heart.
即使这个斑块呢是稳定性的，那但是随着时间呢，它也会慢慢增长变厚，会影响到血液的循流的速度，然后导致心脏出现许多其他的症状。
Over time, blockages can increase in number and severity, affecting many arteries of the heart.
随着时间呢。这个冠状动脉的疾病会使心脏变得衰弱，会导致心脏的功能不佳。
This can weaken the heart and cause it to pump blood poorly.
这样子的话，心脏就会变得衰弱，而且它的那个供血的功能呢，也会慢慢减低。
In addition, blockages can cause abnormal electrical activity within the heart.
冠状动脉疾病呢，也可能导致心脏的节律造成异常。
This can lead to abnormal beating of the heart and cause patients to feel palpitations and even loss of consciousness.
这样会造成那个病人的感觉心率不整，有的时候还会失去一些知觉。
In some instances, this abnormal beating of the heart can be dangerous and even life-threatening.
有些时候呢，这种不规则的跳动呢，会很危险，甚至会影响到生命。
Although blockages can have a negative impact on the overall health of the heart, it can also produce many symptoms that affect a person's quality of life.
冠状动脉的阻塞呢，除了会造成心脏不舒服，减少心脏的血液。有时候也会导致一些其他的不同，心痛的症状。
Classic symptoms include chest pain, chest pressure, or chest heaviness.
典型的心绞痛症状呢，包括胸痛、胸部压迫、胸闷。
It can often be associated with difficulty breathing, pain that moves to the shoulder or jaw, nausea, vomiting, or fatigue.
它通常也会造成了呼吸困难，或是肩之下的疼痛、恶心、呕吐，或是疲劳。
These symptoms can be stable when they occur only with exercise and are relieved with rest.
这种情况呢，在你休息之后呢，可能会减低。
However, symptoms can also be unstable when they occur at lower levels of activity or even at rest.
可是有的时候呢，症状也会增加在你，就算在你休息或是运动量减少的时候。
For many other people, however, the first sign of coronary artery disease may be a heart attack.
可是对很多人讲，冠状动脉疾病的第一个病征呢，就是心脏病。
Although chest pain is a classic symptom, many people may have atypical symptoms.
虽然说胸口痛是一个非常典型的心脏病的这个症状，可是呢，还有很多并非典型的症状。
Women and people with diabetes are at especially high risk for having atypical symptoms.
女性还有糖尿病患者，常常会有非典型的胸痛症状。
Oftentimes, these atypical symptoms can be difficulty breathing, feeling tired, or abdominal pain.
这种非典型的心绞痛，通常呢是有呼吸困难，感觉虚弱。
If chest pain does occur, it is often sharp and stabbing rather than a pressure.
当有心痛的时候呢，这个心痛的感觉通常是非常激烈、非常剧烈，而且有一种很刺痛，而不是有压力的感觉。
But now that we understand that chest pain is one of the most common symptoms of coronary artery disease, is all chest pain from coronary disease?
我们现在已经听说呢，这个心痛呢，心口痛呢，是一个非常典型的心脏病的症状。但是不是每一个心痛都是跟心脏病有关吗？
The answer is no. There are many diseases that can also cause chest pain that is not due to blockages in the arteries of the heart.
其实不是，有很多跟心痛呢，是跟心脏没有关系。
Other heart diseases can also cause chest pain.
其他的心脏病也可以造成胸口疼痛。
These include inflammation of the lining of the heart. Valvular dysfunction, abnormal thickening of the heart wall, or even tearing of an artery of the heart.
其他心脏病的问题呢，也会导致心痛，像是心脏内膜炎或心肌炎、瓣膜官能不良。或是心脏壁异常增厚，或是冠状动脉剥离。
Non-cardiac or heart conditions of chest pain. Can be lung disease, gastrointestinal or esophageal disease, problems with the bone, muscle, skin, or nerves within the chest.
有些胸痛是并非心脏问题所致成。例如肺病、肠胃或是食道疾病、骨骼、肌肉、皮肤或神经问题，或是焦虑或是恐慌，也都可能造成心口痛、胸口痛。
It is important to work closely with their primary care doctor and cardiologist to distinguish which of these problems may be producing symptoms.
所以非常重要，你应该。密切的和您心脏医师进行检查与观察，帮助他们诊断造成胸口痛的原因。
Your doctor can perform many tests and exams to help diagnose the exact cause.
你的医生可以进行不同的检查或是测验，来决定是什么事情造成这个胸口痛。
Depending on the history and a patient's overall risk of having blockages, further testing can be done to diagnose coronary artery disease.
根据每个病人的情况，进一步的检查可以测出来造成这个冠状动脉疾病的原因。
Several things can be at increased risk for having coronary artery disease, including being overweight, a history of smoking, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, alcohol use, diabetes, or family history.
有许多种情况呢，会增加罹患冠状动脉疾病的风险，包括体重过重或肥胖、抽烟、高血压、高胆固醇、体能活动不足、过量饮酒、糖尿病，或者是遗传家族病史。
In fact, 47% of people within the United States have at least one of three important risk factors, including high blood pressure, high cholesterol, or smoking.
在美国呢 ,47% 的人至少有冠状动脉疾病三个关键危险因素中的一个、例如高血压、高胆固醇或是抽烟。
Depending on your symptoms, tests can be done to provide additional information.
依据你的症状呢病情进一步的检查可以测验呢你的冠状动脉疾病是什么样情况。
These tests can tell us about the severity of the blockage, the location of the blockage,the anatomy or anatomical makeup of the blockage, and the overall risk to the heart.
这些检查呢可以告诉我们你的这个冠状疾病呢的地方在哪里严重性多大还有就是它的那个组织怎么样还有就是它将来的发展会如何。
For patients who don't have any active symptoms,but may be at increased risk for blockages in the heart, it is important to use screening tests to determine a patient's risk.
对于这些有些无症状的、可是可能 会、发展成冠状动脉疾病的病人呢、我们有一些方法呢能够来做一些评估。
Risk calculators can be employed to use information such as the patient's age, gender, race, and risk factors to predict one's probability of developing blockages.
我们可以用风险评估、来看这个病人得到动脉疾病的机会。这些因素包括像年纪啊，还有性别啊，还有其他的一些生活习惯。
Blood tests can also be used to screen and identify patients who are at increased risk for having heart events.
血液检查也可以查出来病人是不是有这个得这个疾病的可能，还有它的这个危险性。
A coronary calcium score is a CT scan that provides pictures of the heart and its arteries.
冠状动脉钙化评估是一个 CT scan 可以看到心脏的这个钙化状况。
It can show plaque or blockages in the arteries as well as calcium in the arteries of the heart.
这个造影呢可以看到心脏里面的阻塞情况还有它的那个钙化的情况。
All of these tools can help usdetermine a specific person's risk for developing blockages in the arteries of the heart.
这些检查可以告诉我们这个病人他会得到这个心脏阻塞的危险性有多高。
For patients who already have symptoms, different tests can be used.
对这些有症状的、病人呢我们要用其他的方法来做检查。
An ECG, an echocardiogram or ultrasound of the heart can be used to identify the structure of the heart.
心电图或者心脏超音波检查可以让我们看到这个病人的心脏的架构。
A stress test can be done to look for specific areas of the heart that does not receive enough blood flow.
压力检查呢，可以让我们知道心脏哪一个特别的部分呢得不到足够的血液流通。
A CT angiogram is a CT test that specifically looks for blockages in the arteries of the heart.
CT 血管造影呢可以仔细的看到心脏被阻塞的地方心脏血管被阻塞的地方。
But the most direct and best way to identify blockages is with the heart catheterization.
但是最直接跟最清楚的方法看到这个心脏阻塞的地方呢就是用这个导管插入术。
For people who have risk factors of blockages in the arteries of the heart, the most important thing is preventing blockages from developing or progressing.
对于这个有可能得到冠状动脉疾病，危险因素的病人呢，最好的办法就是预防，避免它变得更严重。
The best way to prevent blockages from developing is lifestyle changes.
最好预防这个斑块沉积的方法呢，就是改变生活形态。
This includes quitting smoking, weight loss, a diet that's high in fruit, vegetables, and fiber, and increased physical activity.
改变生活的形态呢，包括戒烟、减轻体重、多吃水果蔬菜，还有含高纤维的食物。另外就是运动。
For people who lifestyle changes alone is not enough, medications can also be used to control cholesterol, blood pressure, and blood sugar to minimize risk.
如果改变生活形态还是不能预防的病人呢，我们可以用药物来帮忙控制。这个药物是针对胆固醇、血压或者血糖。
Even if coronary artery disease is diagnosed and already present, many treatment options still exist.
就算是你被诊断出有冠状动脉疾病，那我们还是有很多方法来可以来治这个病。
For asymptomatic people, the same risk factor modifications that we spoke about earlier are used to prevent progression of blockages in the arteries of the heart.
对于这个无症状的病人呢，我们是要来改变他的生活习惯，来改变他的这个危险因素。
These include lifestyle changes and medications to control risk factors.
这包括呢，改变生活形态及用药物来矫正他的危险因素。
For patients who are already symptomatic, several therapies also exist.
对于已经有症状的病患呢，我们也有很多方法来可以治疗。
Again, it is important to prevent any progression of blockages.
最重要的呢，还是要预防继续堆这个沉积物的堆积。
Graduated and monitored exercise programs can also be used to improve symptoms.
用这个比较渐进式的这个运动，还有监测他的运动，来这个计划呢，也可以来减缓这个病人的症状。
Medications are often first-line therapies to reduce symptoms and increase a person's exercise tolerance.
药物呢，可以用来治疗这个病人呢，减轻他们的症状，也可以增加他们对于这个运动的承受量。
When people continue to have symptoms despite medications, other therapies like procedures and cardiac catheterizations can be done to help.
如果说是这些症状呢，都还不能够疏解的话呢，我们可以用其他的方法来这个疏解他们的症状，包括心导管检查术。
Cardiac catheterization is a diagnostic procedure where long and flexible tubes are introduced directly into the arteries of the heart.
插导管术是一个诊断冠状动脉疾病的最好的方法。它是用一个细的管子呢，直接穿到这个病人的心脏来诊断。
In this way, we can directly visualize any blockages in the arteries of the heart.
用这个方法呢，我们可以直接看到呢，任何阻塞物或者阻塞的位置，还有阻塞的严重性。
These tubes are typically introduced through either the wrist or the groin, avoiding any need for surgery or incisions.
这个线呢，通常都是由这个在这个手板手呃手腕或是在腹股沟呢，通过这些地方呢穿进心脏，所以这样子呢就不需要做手术或是有切口。
And if necessary, these tubes can introduce equipment to relieve the blockage, including balloons and stents.
如果有必要呢， 其他的仪器也可以经由导管呢进入到心脏来做来去这个解除塞阻塞的物质，像是用气球或者支架。
Catheterization is an important tool to fight coronary artery disease because it is the best test to diagnose blockages.
心导管检查术呢是最好对心的冠状动脉疾病最好的方法，是现在目前的黄金标准检测法。
As we discussed, it allows us to visualize the blockage, the location, and the severity of the blockage.
经过这个方法呢，我们可以看到，直接看到呢，这个堵塞物的位置，还有它的这个堵塞的严重性。
Lastly, catheterization is not just diagnostic, but also potentially therapeutic for treating blockages.
心导管检查术不光是一个诊断的方法，那我们也是算是一个治疗的方法，因为可以用这个方法来做一些治疗的工作。
If a blockage is identified, it can be addressed with a stent.
如果呢，在做这个检查术的时候呢，看到有堵塞物，那这个堵塞物呢，是我们可以用一个方法把它移开，或是把它张开。
A stent is a thin metal mesh or scaffold that can open up or prop up an area of narrowing.
在这个情况下，我们可以放一个支架进去。那个支架是一种很薄的金属网或是框架，可以在窄小的地方呢固定或是撑开这个动脉。
A stent also traps any plaque or blockages and restores blood flow to the artery.
支架呢也可以帮忙捕获一些堵塞物，这样子的话就可以恢复动脉的正常血流。
New stents these days can also release medications to help prevent future narrowing.
新的支架呢也可以把药物放进去，这样的话这个药物就可以防止未来血管继续狭窄。
So what are the benefits of heart catheterization?
心导管检查的益处是什么呢？
We discussed that it's a very accurate tool for diagnosing blockages and can be therapeutic for treating blockages.
这个检查方法呢，除了是做诊断用，也可以来做治疗用。
During a catheterization, additional tests such as ultrasound and pressure measurements can be performed to assess the anatomy and significance of any blockage.
其他检查也可以在心导管检查的过程中进行包括超声波或是压力测验，这样子我们可以来评估这个血管的结构和堵塞的严重性跟它的程度。
Most importantly, stents and cardiac catheterization are very effective in reducing chest symptoms and improving a person's overall quality of life.
装支架跟这个心导管检查呢，可以大大的减少病人的症状。然后改善他们的生活品质。
However, what does a cardiac catheterization not do?
但是呢，心导管检查的方法还是有很多事情不能做的。
Heart catheterizations have never been shown to prevent future heart attacks or death from heart disease in the presence of stable coronary artery disease.
在这个稳定的冠状动脉疾病的呢，这个心导管检查并不见能够避免它未来出现心脏病发作的可能，或是因心脏病而死亡的风险。
In addition, catheterization may not completely eliminate all symptoms.
而且呢，心导管检查可能没有办法消除所有的症状。
It is important to discuss the pros and cons of every therapy with your physician.
很重要是你需要跟你的医生讨论每一个这个手术呢，或是说是检查术的好利与弊，在你做之前。
So when should patients with coronary artery disease seek immediate medical care?
什么时候呢？冠状动脉疾病患者应该寻求这个紧急照顾呢？
Although many patients with stable coronary artery disease may be safely monitored by their doctor, there are conditions in which patients should seek immediate help.
虽然许多稳定型冠状动脉病患呢，是可以由他的心脏科医师呢安全的进行监测，但是如果你有下列情况呢，应该立即寻求紧急医疗照顾。
Some of these conditions include chest pain or difficulty breathing at rest or with minimal activity.
这些情况比如说在你休息的时候或是你在非常轻微活动的时候呢出现心痛或是气短的现象。
Symptoms that are more severe than usual.
或是你的症状呢比平常更严重。
Symptoms that last longer than usual.
或是比平常持续的时间更长。
And the presence of new symptoms associated with chest pain.
或是出现与胸痛有关的新症状。
So with that, I'd like to conclude by stating that coronary artery disease is a very common disease in this country.
结论呢是冠状动脉疾病是一个非常常见和普通的疾病。
Untreated or undertreated coronary artery disease can have serious consequences for a person's heart health.
如果不经治疗或是不足够治疗的话或治疗不当会造成心脏很大的严重后果。
The main goals of treatment continue to be prevention, lifestyle changes, and the reduction of symptoms.
我们治疗最主要的目标呢是预防改变你的生活形态及减少你的症状。
Medications are the mainstay of symptom treatment, but procedures such as heart catheterizations can be helpful under specific circumstances.
药物治疗呢是这个治疗症状的主要方法，但是在有些情况之下呢，也可以用这个导管插入术呢减轻你的症状。
Most importantly,You should speak with your cardiologist or primary care doctor to learn more.
最重要是要与你的家庭医师还有你的心脏科医师讨论，以便了解更多关于这个疾病的资料。
Thank you very much.
谢谢您。
各位世界日报的读者，大家好，我是纽约长老会皇后医院健康发展部的主任杨明德。我们在2021年很高兴又能够继续跟世界日报为你们提供一连串的健康教育讲座。纽约长老会皇后医院秉着我们一向的宗旨，提供最优良、最前进跟最好的医疗服务给我们的社区。如果您有任何问题或是想要跟我们的专家预约，您可以打电话给我们的办公室 718-670-1178。 谢谢。